After they had left Miss Pross, Carton led the way to Tellison's, which was only a few minutes' walk. Mr. Lorry had just finished dinner and was greatly surprised when they entered. Carton introduced the visitor. So after dropping Miss Pross, Carton led his way to Tellison's along with John Prasad. And they reached to Tellison's. Mr. Lorry, he has finished his dinner. And Carton introduced the visitor to Mr. Lorry. Miss Pro's brother, Sir Mr. Prasad. Prasad, I know this name and the face. I told you, you had a memorable face, Mr. Prasad. Please sit down. So then Jerry Cruncher, he introduces Prasad to Mr. Lorry. Mr. Lorry said, I am familiar with this name. I think I have seen this face somewhere. Please sit down. Then Carton turned to Mr. Lorry with a frown. He was a witness at that trial. Then Carton, he intervened in between and he said he was a witness at the trial. The case that was heard at Old Bailey, that was against Charles Turney, the treason case. They were talking about that. Mr. Lorry immediately remembered and cast a look of hatred towards his visitor. Carton briefly explained that Miss Prose had recognized her brother earlier and gave the sad news of Turney's second arrest. The old gentleman was shocked. So now Mr. Lorry, he remembered, but now he was giving a look of dislike to Prasad. Carton also told Mr. Lorry that Miss Prose, now she know about the second arrest of Charles Darnay. By hearing that news that Charles was arrested for the second time, the old gentleman, Mr. Lorry, was all shocked. Unfortunately, Dr. Manette's influence could not save him this time, Mr. Lorry. This is a desperate time when desperate games are played for desperate strikes. My strike is for a friend in the consigliere, and the friend I am to win is Mr. Prasad. So Carton started explaining that now this time Dr. Manette's influence couldn't help Charles Tuarne in order to get out of the prison. Now they have to do anything else. So now they have to make efforts in order to save Charles Tuarne's life. He said, that is the reason that I brought Mr. Prasad here, so that we can save Charles Tuarne's life. You need to have a good card, sir, said the spy. Carton poured himself some water and drank a glassful. Then he put the glass thoughtfully on the table. Well, let's see. I know a great deal about you. First of all, I know that you were a spy for the old government. I also know that you were a spy for the English against the French. Shall I go on? What cards do you have? So now Mr. Prasad come to know that why Sidney Carton brought him here, because they want Prasad's help in order to help Charles Turney. So Prasad, he was trying to play clever, but Sidney Carton, he cut his point by saying that I know some secrets of you, Mr. Prasad. Don't try to be oversmart. I know that you were a spy for the old government. And I also know that you were a spy for English against the French. Shall I reveal your secrets to the citizen committee? Prasad said nothing. He clearly held the poorer hand. My ace card, Mr. Prasad, is that I know enough about you to report you to the citizens committee. But that would make you no better than a common spy yourself. So Sidney Carton explained that I will not report against you. I just want your help so that we can help Charles Tuarne. so that he can get out of the prison. But if you are going to act over smartly, then I will reveal your secret to citizens committee, and after that your all ranks will be taken back and you will become a common spy. I am playing my ace, Mr. Prasad. In a few minutes, Prasad looked at Cotton angrily, but he accepted defeat. All right, what do you want of me? You are a jailer at the Consigliere, yes, sometimes. But you can come and go as you please, yes, good, now we can talk. So, when Cotton has said that he can reveal his secret to the citizens committee, then Prasad, he agreed to help them. Then Cotton continued that you are a jailer at Consigliere. He says, yes, sometimes. He says, but you are free to go inside and come out. He said, yes. I want a person who was having this sort of work. So now we can talk. When Prasad gone, Sidney Cotton talked to Mr. Lorry, who was grieved to learn about Charles' situation. And I thought everything was going to be all right. I have to pass to leave France and I'm ready to go. How is poor Lucy doing, Mr. Lorry? So when Prasad, he left Tellison's office, Sidney Cotton talked to Mr. Lorry, and Mr. Lorry, he felt bad about Charles' situation and he was also worried about Lucy. Sidney Cotton also inquired about Lucy's condition. Anxious and unhappy but very beautiful. Oh, it was a long sigh, almost like a sob. It attracted Mr. Lorry's eyes to Cotton's face. A shadow passed across it. It is as swiftly as cloud sweeps over a sunny hillside. The light of the fire made him look pale, with his long brown hair hanging loose about him. I had better not seen her, Mr. Lorry. She might think a thousand things and became even more troubled. Please do not speak of me to her. So Sidney Cotton, he was also feeling very bad for Lucy, that she was again troubled and she was in difficult situation. So he said to Mr. Lorry that please don't tell about me to Lucy because she'll become more worried. Cotton decided to walk with Mr. Lorry to Lucy's home. He left the old gentleman there but lingered at a short distance. Then he turned back to shut the gate and touched it. He had heard of her going to La Force every day. She came out here, turned this way, must have walked on these stones often. Let me follow her steps. So Sidney Cotton decided not to meet Lucy because she will be troubled and she is going to think a lot that why Sidney Cotton came here, what is the purpose of his visit and all that other things. But he dropped Mr. Lorry there at Manette House, and after that he followed the way which Lucy used to follow daily in order to reach to that point from where Charles Turner can see her from the window that was in the prison. So he started following her footsteps.